Basketball star Jordan Farmar does lots to give back to the community. And on February 7th, his foundation, the Jordan Farmar Foundation, will hold a fundraiser. It's an evening where people could come together, have something to drink, something to eat, and do something nice. Giving back tickets are $200 per person. If you can, do what you can to give back. For more information, check out www.farmargives.org. In a second, I'm going to play a clip here of what the Jordan Farmar Foundation is all about. They give back. They help the homeless. They help kids with needs. They help kids in hospitals. So make sure, if you can, take part in this. The Jordan Farmar Foundation at their event in Malibu. More information, farmargives.org.
NBA star Jordan Farmar held a phenomenal event at the Salute Bar in Santa Monica, where he displayed his passion for his foundation.
Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Very well.
And it means a lot, and not just to John Paul. I mean, we have a long journey ahead of us, but you've always made it possible, and it helps. And I don't have enough money in the world to tell you how much that means to me.
It's a passion Jordan Farmar has that few people know about. The NBA star loves putting smiles on children's faces. Children hospitalized at Mattel's Children's Hospital at UCLA with very serious illnesses.
Trying to help people out. I've been blessed and put in a situation where I can give back and make an impact on other people's lives. It's a great feeling. I mean, it's just like, you know, making a good pass in the game and seeing somebody else be successful. When you can do something to really make an impact and benefit somebody else, it feels great.
Sean Paul, do you know who this is?
Yes.
Who is it?
Trevor Ariza.
How do you know Trevor Ariza? You've seen him at the games? Is he good?
Yes.
8-year-old John Paul has a rare blood disorder. Since birth, he's received blood transfusions every 2 weeks. He's also a huge Lakers fan. Who is that?
Luke Walton.
Really? How do you know?
I watch him on TV. There
you go. Luke, do you know Sean Paul?
Yeah, we go way back.
He said you go way back.
Thank you.
John Paul's mom, Marisol, is one of the most courageous people you'll ever meet.
Not only are we going through what John Paul's going through, but Jordan's making dreams come true made my husband's dream come true last year. My husband is terminally ill and is dying of Lou Gehrig's disease. And he just turned 40 last month. Last year when John Paul was turning 7, his dream was to go to a Laker game. And Jordan went one step ahead. He didn't just say, okay, you know, watch it from the seats. He extended his box seating. John Paul had the birthday of his life. This year, my husband is on a ventilator and a feeding tube. Doesn't get to see his kids as often. Wasn't able to be part of John Paul's birthday. And he knew that we were coming to this event tonight. He can't speak. We can only read his lips and figure it out by an alphabetical chart. So when my daughter called him today, through his caregiver, his message to Mindy was, thank you for everything that you've done for my family. And for Jordan, it was go Lakers.
You know, that definitely touched my heart. I'm sure it touched everybody's heart that was in there. And, you know, that's a good cause. Hope little John Paul gets better and, you know, he's able to live a good life from here on out.
Take a lot for granted, you know, when you're faced with terminal illness and, you know, life-threatening diseases, kind of gives you perspective. So you got a real clear example of what's important to her. And I'm just very happy and proud that Jordan's able to do something to help someone like that.
Fisher,
why do you like Fisher?
Yes.
Why?
Because he's short. He's short and he runs fast.
Yeah. Luke Walton, Jordan's teammate, tells me that for the past 3 years, Farmar has been hosting kids like John Paul at Lakers games.
You know, every game we're meeting other kids, and you know, this is the city he grew up in, so he's doing a good job of helping the city out now that he's in a good position.
So how did it happen that one of the NBA's most talented point guards got involved in something so serious? Mindy Kulani, Jordan's mom, explains.
As you know, Ellie, when Jordan was, you know, in high school, I said, do two things for me. Take care of your sister if anything happens to me, and start a charity for me. So I wanted Jordan to choose a charity that was close to his heart so that, you know, 10 years down the road, he'd still have the passion for it.
And you've gone with him to the hospitals. What's that like?
It's very exciting. I mean, it's nice to help other people and give back, and obviously he can do that. And so I definitely feel good helping him and participating in it.
But this night was much more than a friendly get-together. Jordan unveiled his next goal, raising funds to build a green room at the hospital where kids could just be kids, play video games, relax, and learn about the environment, getting a break from all the medical treatments. And everyone is invited to chip in. This time, you could give Jordan an assist.
That it allows children to realize that, you know what, besides everything that we go through, there is a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. And that pot of gold is Jordan Farmar.
Jordan eagerly anticipates the green room to come to fruition. In Santa Monica, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.